The killer awoke before dawn. He put his boots on. He took a face from the ancient gallery and he walked on down the hall. He went into the room where his sister lived and then he paid a visit to his brother and then he walked on down the hall and he came to a door and he looked inside. Father, yes, son, I want to kill you. Mother, I want to. Come on, baby, take a chance with us. Come on, baby, take a chance with us. Come on, baby, take a chance with us and meet me at the back of the blue bus. Do not blue rock on that blue. Thank you.
Captain Willard, are you in there?
Yeah, I'm coming.
What do you want?
Are you all right, Captain?
How's it look like?
Are you Captain Willard? 505th Battalion, 173rd Airborne,
yeah.
Signed SOG.
Hey, buddy, you gonna shut the door?
Hey, take it easy, huh, Captain? We have orders to escort you to the airfield.
Where are the charges?
Sir?
Charges, what did I do?
There's no charges, Captain. You have orders to report to ComSec Intelligence at Nha Trang.
Trang, for me.
Not Trang. That's right, Captain. That's right. But come on, Captain. We still have a few hours left.
Okay.
Captain?
Yeah.
Come on.
Up you go. Up you go.
No, don't be an ass.
Get a hold of him good. We're going to take a shower, Captain.
Come on. In we go.
Oh, no, God damn it.
Get up. In we go.
Come on.
Get underneath. Stand underneath that
cap.
Right.
Oh, my God.
I
heard
you, bastard.
Let me see that hand, Captain. Look, I want you to try and get that underneath the water, too, huh? There you go.
God, Christ.
Stick your head under that.
Where are you from?
Military intelligence, Captain.
I mean, where back home?
Needles, California. You know where that is?
Well, I need a mission.
Yeah, well, I think you might have one now, Captain. Get you squared away to get there.
You know anything about it?
No.
Hell, you said.
No, I don't know anything about it.
Bullshit. You guys know about it, man?
I just came to get you, Captain. Here, take this back. I think I can finish it up right now.
Captain Willard reporting, sir.
Captain, come on in.
Thank you, sir.
Stand at ease.
Captain.
Captain, have you ever seen this gentleman before?
No, sir.
Met the general or myself?
Not personally, sir.
Worked a lot on your own, haven't you, Willard?
Yes, sir, I have, when the operation required, sir.
Your report specifies intelligence, counterintelligence, with ComSec I-Corps.
Sir, I'm not presently disposed to discuss those operations.
Oh, didn't you work for the CIA and I-Corps?
No, sir.
Did you not assassinate a government tax collector, Quantri Province, June 18, 1968? Captain?
No, sir. Sir, I'm not aware of any such operation. And nor would I be at liberty to discuss such an operation if it did in fact exist. Sir.
I thought we'd have a bite of lunch while we talked. I hope you brought a good appetite, Captain. I noticed that you have a bad hand there. Are you wounded?
Oh, no, sir. A little fishing accident on R&R, sir.
Oh, but you're fit for duty.
Oh, yes, General. Very much so, sir.
Well, let's see what we have here. Roast beef, and usually it's not bad. Try some, Jerry, and pass it around. Save a little time. We might pass both ways. Captain, I don't know how you feel about this shrimp, but if you'll eat it, you'll never have to prove your courage in any other way. Oh, Captain, what do you think of the Special Forces?
Well, I've had occasion to work with them, sir. Very impressive. What I mean is, I haven't thought about him that much. I saw the movie.
What movie?
Green Berets, General. John Wayne.
Oh, yes. We gave cooperation to that movie. God knows how many troops, how many helicopters we furnished to make the green beanies look like soldiers.
What, in your estimation, is the mission of Special Forces, Captain?
Say again, sir.
What is the mission of the Green Beret?
Oh, sir, primarily it's counterinsurgency warfare with indigenous troops and the like.
Yes, they're the elite troops. I know that. And they are our new breed. I realize that. Question that I have, Captain, about the Special Forces is under whose control are they?
You heard of Colonel Walter E. Lely, Captain?
Yeah, I've heard the name, yes, sir.
Operations Officer, 5th Special... Operations Officer, 5th Special Forces.
Yes, let me see that.
Lately commands the CIDG, Civilian Regular Defense Group. The Braves have around 25 of these camps all along the Cambodian border. 300-400 natives advised by 7 Americans. Mostly Montagnards, Nungs, Rods, Hakamal, Mai.
The itinerary for your stay will be to tour our facility to get a better picture of our mission in the Central Highlands. Tomorrow, you'll be flown to Cameron Bay to observe the Vietnamization program in progress. As you know, this is a program which includes training and teaching the Arvin forces. Later on today, we will host a gourmet dinner of steak and ice cream and your choice of beverages flown in from Saigon. And now, ladies and gentlemen, if you'll follow me, we'll begin our tour of the facility.
This was a man of honor, a man of principle, a fine professional soldier who was justifiably proud of his magnificent achievements. It's too much for the man to bear.
Now he's crossed into Cambodia with this private Montagnard army of his that worship the man like a god and follow his every order, however ridiculous.
Ambition of an officer is to be expected. It's admirable. But Colonel Lilly has gone beyond the bounds of permitted aspirations. However, let's try to put ourselves in his shoes. Man with his bridges burned, he's surrounded by a group of primitives who do adore him, gratify every wish, every whim. And remember, too, in this war, things have got confused. Power, ideals, the old morality, and practical military necessity. But out there with these natives, it must be a temptation to be God. Because there's a conflict in every human heart. Between the rational and the irrational. between good and evil. And good does not always triumph. Sometimes the dark side overcomes what Lincoln called the better angels of our nature. Every man has got a breaking point. You and I have. Well, Livy has reached his. And very obviously he has gone insane. But what is far worse is that he's become a savage, and he's still in the field commanding troops. And he has gone beyond any pale of civilized behavior or control. I want to hear a tape. Colonel, would you play that tape for the captain, please?
It's a monitor of Cambodia, Captain.
We need a man to take a hazardous trip. We're looking for a man who has experience in this type of mission, which you have. And we're looking for a man who's good at it, which you are. But above all, we're looking for a man who loves his country and who is absolutely loyal to the Army. So the question we come down to, Captain Willard, is, are you that man?
Yes, sir, of course. I have been off for a bit, but I assure you, sir, I'm able, fit, and quite willing to accept whatever assignment it is you intend for me.
Well, I do have some good news for you, Captain. I recommended you for promotion. In a few weeks, when the paperwork's completed, you'll be entitled to wear oak leaves on your collar. Look, you have those. I asked Captain Lucan to get these because I thought that you might want to take them with you on the mission, and when you get back, I'll be glad to pin them on you personally.
Thank you, John. I'm honored. I look forward to returning, sir.
I want to emphasize that this mission is voluntary. Without jeopardizing your promotion or your career in any way at all, you may refuse it if you wish.
Well, sir, I understand that, and I accept with pride, sir.
Your mission is to proceed up the Nung River in a Navy patrol boat. Pick up Colonel Lely's path at Nu Mung Ba. Follow it, learn what you can along the way. When you find the Colonel, infiltrate his team by whatever means available and terminate the Colonel's command.
Say again, sir.
Terminate Colonel Lely's command. That's the job, son.
You understand, Captain, that this mission does not exist, nor will it ever exist.
Terminate the Colonel.
Terminate with extreme prejudice.
I can't. Captain Willett, Quartermaster Chief Phillips, sir. Glad to have you aboard, sir.
Thank you.
The captain, meet our crew. Engineman Second Class Hicks. We call him the chef.
Afternoon, sir.
Hicks?
It's Gunner's Mate Third Class Miller, otherwise known as Mr. Clean.
Afternoon, sir.
Guess. You call him Clean?
Well, everything he does is incredibly clean, sir. Just spick and span.
I bet he does.